My son Frankie is now 19 years old. 19 years old, high school graduate. He has all his shots, ladies. People tell me all the time, you know, why do you talk about your son so much? Because he won't leave. Does he like it when you talk about him? I said, no, he hates it. Well, why do you do it? Because he won't leave. I'll tell you what he likes to do right now. He likes to sit around the house and watch videos of other kids playing video games. See, some of you are clapping. I didn't know that was an actual thing. I asked him, what are you doing? I'm watching other kids playing video games. I said, that's really? Why? Well, they're professionals. I'm like, why would you watch something that you could be doing? Because they're professionals. That's dumb. Really, Dad? Every Sunday, I see you watching football. How come you don't play? I didn't even argue, I just cut off the internet.
My children give me guilt trips I wouldn't even contemplate. Like, my daughter was in a play on Thursday and Friday, so I went on Thursday night, and then Friday morning she saw me with my Rolly bag, and she was like, oh, you're not coming to my show tonight? I'm like, you've never been to one of my shows. I do 300 a year! My big plan was to teach my children responsibility by selling posters after one of my shows. So I texted my teenager, I'm like, do you want to sell posters after my show? I'll pay you. She texted back, great, sounds good. So then I texted my teenager, I'm like, do you want to sell posters after my show? I'll pay you. He texted back, no thanks, I don't need the money. He doesn't have any money. He has my money. I just texted back, you're out of the will. I'm kidding, he was never in it. If my father asked me to do something, he wouldn't even stick around for an answer. You want to shovel the driveway? And then he'd just leave. It was understood I was going to shovel the driveway or move out. I was kind of frightened of my dad. My children treat me like some bank teller they reluctantly have to deal with. Once a week, they just appear in front of me. Mom said I could get a shark. So I guess I need your credit card. I'm like, what the hell are you talking about? He's yelling again, Mom!
My daughter and I are closer than we ever been, man. My daughter's boy crazy. Boy crazy. Once again, I gotta act like I like it. I don't, but you gotta act like you do. I love this. I love that in my specials, you get to see the growth of my fucking kids. You see their development. They're getting older, man. Daughter told me she likes this boy named Matt to go to her school. Dad, I like this boy named Matt. Oh my God, he's so cute. He makes me laugh. I want him. What the fuck does that mean? What does that mean? I want him. What the fuck are you saying, little girl? Should I tell him? If that's how you feel, honey, tell him. My daughter goes to school, tells the boy how she feels. She comes home. Dad, oh my God, guess what? Matt likes me back. We're a thing. Good for you, honey. That makes me happy. Do me a favor. Keep it in the kids' space, though. Okay, Dad. She comes back home 2 days later. Dad, I don't like Matt no more. I like this boy named Rob now. He look better. He make me laugh more. That's who I really want. It happens, honey. Sometimes you think you like somebody, then you meet somebody else, and you realize that's the person that you liked all along. It's called life. Make it happen. Move on. Be honest with the other person. All right, Dad, I love you. Keep it in the kid's face. A week goes by. Dad, I don't like Rob no more. I like this boy named Tim. Instantly, in my mind, I said, my daughter a hoe. This is hoe shit. This is hoe shit. Hoe activity right in front of my face. I immediately called the hoe that I knew from the past. Asked her if this is how it went down for her. Three boys back to back. She said, yup, the same way. Thing I knew, I was plucking balls in the bathroom. What the fuck is happening? With my baby plucking balls, I gotta save her.
I feel like I'm a better parent when I'm not there. Like, when something happens for my family, if I'm gone, it's so much better. My daughter's got their periods. Ooh, that was a pause, huh? the guys on the top row are like, all right, I'm gonna go get another beer real quick. My daughter's got their periods. Now, Georgia got hers first. She's the oldest. That's how that works. I wasn't there, thank God, because I would have fucked that up royally. I would have been like, all right, you go to the river and do laundry for a week. You're dirty. Go and get. Now, Georgia, just to paint the picture, is a simple moron. Like a very good-hearted Christian moron. Just doesn't know what she's saying. We were playing categories one time. You know where you roll the dice, letter comes up, fill out all the categories? Me, Georgia, and Isla. We roll the letter N. I look at Isla. First one is U.S. states. I go, Isla, what did you put for U.S. states to start with N? And she goes, couldn't think of one. I go, you're in eighth grade. You couldn't think of one state that started with the letter N? And she goes, no, could you? And I go, yeah, Nevada. She goes, never heard of it. I go, Georgia, what did you put? She goes, New Hampshire. I was like, Isla, is that a state? I thought that was a province. Next one, street names. I go, Isla, what'd you put for street names to start with letter N? And she goes, Nebraska. I'm like, bitch! That's what I put. I go, Georgia, what did you put for street names to start with the letter N? And she goes, I think I did this wrong. I go, what did you put for street names to start with the letter N, Georgia? And she goes, I don't want to tell you guys. I think I'm going to keep it to myself. I'm like, no, you're definitely fucking telling us. She goes, I wrote Notorious B.I.G. Wasn't that his street name? I'm like, you beautiful fucking idiot. Yes, it was. She got her period. On a Saturday night, in the middle of the night, woke up Sunday morning, bleeding, freaking out, crack of dawn. I was on the road, thank God. Walked into our bedroom, woke up my wife, 5 a.m, bleeding and crying. Her exact words were, Mommy, I'm not ready to be a big girl today. It breaks your heart, it really does. My wife is a fucking gangster. I joke a lot about her. She's a bad motherfucker. Dude, she scooped her up, took her out to the living room, put her down on the couch, put some towels down, I hope. Went out, got donuts, came home, started season 1, episode 1 of Downton Abbey, and that became their show. That was George's entrance into womanhood. That's how they bonded. I came home, I didn't even know anything had happened. I was drunk, obviously. We had just put our new pool in, so I go and I grab Isla, I take her outside, I throw her in the pool. I grab Georgia, you already know it, don't you? The second I grab her, she goes, get your hands off me! I'm like, whoa, 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 you do not talk to your father like that. Isla pops up out of the pool. Dad, we got a bleeder! Georgia starts crying immediately. Leanne yells at me. I end up in the pool with Isla drinking a double Tito's and soda. Getting the full rundown. Isla's like, Dad, I followed the tracks into Mom's room. I go, you followed tracks? She goes, like a hunter, Dad. Looks at me dead in the face and goes, hey, Dad, I promise you right now, I'll never get my period. I was like, really? She goes, yeah, I'll always be your best little buddy. I almost started crying in the pool because I was like, how stupid is she?
You know, my son ran up to me one time. This is a true story. I was in my room and he ran up to me. He always fucks with me, but because he's got such a beautiful head of hair, right? It's fucking beautiful, man. And he looks like one of the Jacksons from The Five, like, hey, like. And he comes up to me, Malcolm, and he goes, Dad, when I get older, am I gonna be bald like you? And that hurt me so bad. Like, he doesn't understand how hard that hurt. And I was like, so I wanted to like let him know that it hurt, but not with words, just by my tone. I was like, you know what, Joe? You get your hair from your mom's side. And on your mom's side, everyone has a full head of hair. That's probably why you have so much hair. So you don't have to be worried about being bald like your dad. And my son goes, sweet. Sweet. And went to his fucking room like an asshole. And I was crushed. I was like, man, fuck this kid, man. That's why anytime you ask a question, I have an opportunity to knock him down. I do it, Malcolm. Fuck him, man. He came up to me like 2 weeks after that, and he was like, Dad, he was like all sad. Dad, can I talk to you for a second, please? And you promise you won't make a joke? Yeah, I promise. No, I'm serious, Dad. Like, it's been bothering me, and I need to talk to you about this. So please, no joke. All right, Joe, talk to me. What's wrong? Why are you crying? What's wrong? Okay, I don't even know how to say this. Okay, I've been growing my pubic hairs for a couple years now. Joe, you gotta warn me about the topic. Like, you can't just come in hot like that, man. You gotta warn me, let me know. I'm trying to eat lunch right now. Now I've got pubic hairs on my mind. All right, come on, Dad. You said you were gonna not joke around. I'm being serious. Like, listen to me. I've been growing my pubic hairs for a while now, like for a couple years. Okay, yeah, you're a teenager, Joe. That's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to grow your pubic hairs. So what's bothering you? Why is that making you mad? No, just listen to me. Okay, I'm listening. What? What's bothering you? Okay, well, I always thought, Dad, that once you start to grow your pubic hairs, that the penis was supposed to start growing. Yeah, and? My penis isn't growing, Dad. Just my pubic hairs. My penis is still the same size from 2 years ago, but my pubic hairs are long, Dad. It just keeps growing. I don't get it, Dad. Dad. Dad! Dad! And I didn't know what to do. I just got on my phone like, what the fuck? He's like, what are you doing, Dad? And I was like, I'm canceling that DNA test.
My other responsibility as a dad with my daughter is to teach her how a man is supposed to treat her. Yep, big difference. Right. So yes, I will be hard on my son and I will spoil my daughter because I reserve the right to ruin some man's life too someday. And I want my daughter's future husband to hear nothing from her but my daddy, my father. This is not how I am to be treated. My daddy told me, my daddy. And I also want that little girl to grow up to be exactly like my wife. Oh, yeah. Because I want my wife to know what the fuck it's like to live with her, too. Oh, I want her to get her payback. And some of you women are having daughters becoming teenagers, and you can't figure out why you and her can't get along. Well, congratulations, you have met yourself. And your husband loves it when you come to him like this. Go talk to your daughter right now. Why? Because she has an attitude problem. She doesn't take no for an answer, and she spends every dollar that we give her. And your husband's just sitting there going, wow, you know anybody like that? Oh, shut up. Your payback's coming because she's gonna marry a dumbass like you and give you both Bell's palsy. Payback, bitch.